Hi guys, and welcome to Battlefield 1. Today, we're going to bust all the Battlefield 1 myths, questions, tips and tricks, and much more regarding the light tank. After this video, you will have absolutely no problem taking out the light tank. I will focus on how to kill the light tank with another tank, and I will share all the pro tips that nobody wants to share. This video is going to be very detailed with a lot of statistics, so let's get started. I will start with one of the biggest tips. When you look at the light tank, do you see this ugly little thing? This is not there for aesthetic reasons. This is armor, protection, it will cover your butt, literally. This thing works so well that it actually makes sense to drive backwards. People think I'm crazy when they see me driving backwards across the battlefield, and I can see you smiling right now, but this thing will keep you alive a lot longer. Instead of hitting you 4 or 5 times to kill you, they will now have to hit you 6 times to kill you. But they will never reach 6 times, because by then they will be dead. If they are good and they hit you in a sweet spot, which I will explain in a minute, then they will only have to hit you 4 times to kill you. If they hit this armor plate, then they will have to hit you 6 times. This is a 50% increase in damage that you can absorb with your light tank. This is a massive advantage. Before I go further into details, I will explain the standard hit points first, and I will prove to you that it makes sense to drive backwards. This is Buddy. You all know him from the previous videos. He's going to help us today so that you can easily kill Buddy in his tank on the battlefield. Let's take a closer look at Buddy's light tank. As you can see, the light tank has 2 exposed tracks, a turret, the engine, and an armor plate at the back. The tracks and the turret are destructible parts. Meaning that if you focus your fire on these parts, you will disable this part of the tank. 2 direct hits will disable them. But the damage is different. Shooting at the tracks will cost 30 damage and the turret will only cost 22. Just for info, we are shooting with a heavy tank. Later you will see the stats when shooting with a light tank. There are a few situations where it would make sense to focus on shooting the tracks. There are a few situations where you would focus on the turret, and sometimes it's just better to deal as much damage in the shortest time possible. It all depends on the situation and you will have to figure that out yourself. What I can show you is the damage model. The damage model will give you the advantage over every other tank on Battlefield 1, and it is very similar to the damage model in Battlefield 4. As you know, there is a difference in damage when you shoot at the front, side or rear, but also the angle is important, and this will win every fight for you. The basic values are as follows. A perpendicular hit to the front will deal 33 damage, the side 32, the engine on the top 30, the engine on the paint 26, and most importantly, the armor plate only 18. Please don't try to remember these numbers, that would complicate things way too much. Let's keep it simple. All this means is that 4 hits to the front, side or the engine will kill the tank. Just remember that. I mentioned the armor plate in the beginning and I told you that it was pretty special. If you shoot at this part of the tank, you will only cause 18 damage. 4 times 18 is 72, so that means that those 4 shots that you fired before, that would have normally killed the tank, now only do 72 damage. This is a massive difference. 5 shots is 90 damage, so you still aren't even able to kill the tank. It will take 6 shots to do that. This means that you are now going to win every 1v1 tank fight. It will take a long time before everyone will figure this out, so at this point, you have a massive advantage. In Battlefield 4, you were dealing an enormous amount of damage to the other tank if you hit it from behind. And a lot of people think that this is still valid. Also for the light tank in Battlefield 1. Psychological warfare at its best. Use this to your advantage and let them think that they are doing massive damage. They will drop their guard and they will be very surprised to see that you are kicking their ass. But they will only realize after they are dead. And yes, they are going to call you a cheater, because in their minds, this is not possible. Because they know that they shot your tank from behind, and whatever you do or say, you won't be able to change their mind. If you are a nice guy, then you could tell them and you could send them to Fog of Gaming to check out this video. I would appreciate that very much. But if you are less nice, then just keep that big smile on your face and kick their ass again and again. Back to our damage model. I told you that the angle made a big difference. This was true in Battlefield 4, and this is also valid in Battlefield 1. A common tactic amongst pro tank drivers in Battlefield 4 was to put your tank at a 45 degree angle. This would give you the maximum damage reduction. This was much better than letting the other guy hit you head on. Imagine that you and me are in a tank fight in Battlefield 4. We are facing each other, we are not moving, and you get to fire the first shot. Then I will fire and so on. When you fire your fourth shot, you will kill me, so I will lose. Basically, whoever fires first wins. Now we are going to do a second fight. But this time, I will place my tank at a 45 degree angle, which means that you will do a lot less damage per bullet this time. Now, I'm a nice guy, so I will let you fire first. If you didn't know about this, then you are going to be very surprised after you fired your fourth shot, because you are expecting to kill me, but I will still be standing. And now, it is my turn to fire. And I think you know already what is going to happen next. You are going to die, even though you were the one who fired first. And all I did was move my tank in a slightly different position. You cannot believe how few people knew about this in Battlefield 4. And these are the same guys that you will be playing against in Battlefield 1. So now you know. I could give you all the statistics that tell you the damage reduction at each different angle and so on, but it would mean absolutely nothing. It will complicate things way too much. So I will make it easy for you. Always try to keep your tank in a 45 degree angle to your enemy, and at the same time, try to hit your enemy perpendicular. Everything that is not perpendicular will reduce the damage, and eventually you might need an extra shot to kill him. I will show it here. This is a very small reduction in angle, but it clearly shows that every few degrees you will lose a damage point. The difference between 25 and 24 damage is one extra shot. 24 times 4 is only 96 and you will not get that kill. Which means that even though you fired first, you might not be the one who will win this fight. If you decide to do what I do and drive backwards, then you can afford to fire one extra shot, because the other guy will have to fire two extra shots. The armor plate will only cause 18 damage and the angle doesn't even matter. They can shoot it from the front, the side or at any other angle, it does not matter. It will only take 18 damage. If you are facing another fan of Fog of Gaming and he is also driving backwards, then you will still have a fighting chance. Try to get close because there is a small sweet spot where you can still do 30 damage to his tank. If you shoot the turret, you will do 22 damage. It doesn't matter from which direction because it is round. Just underneath the turret and right above the armor plate, you will see the engine and this will cause 30 damage. Up close, this looks like a big target, but as soon as you increase the distance a little bit, you will see how small it is. It is very difficult to hit and you are more than likely to end up hitting the turret or the armor plate. The second way to do damage to another fan is to hit the tracks. This will also cause 30 damage. But be careful, it is very easy to miss and to miss is even worse than hitting that armor plate. Just for info, there is another sweet spot, but it is extremely small. If you hit the turret directly on the barrel, you will do 27 damage. But it is very rare to hit this part in an actual tank fight. If you use a light tank to kill another tank, then know that all the principles that I just told you are still valid. The only difference is that the amount of damage that you will cause will be less. So I will give you the short and easy version. Damage to the front is just below 30, damage to the side is slightly more than 20, and you will do 15 damage to the armor plate. Your light tank has different kinds of ammo. Never use the one that looks like a shotgun shell. You won't do any damage, so forget about it. Only use it to kill infantry. Some of you might be wondering why I am releasing this video at this very moment. They announced that they are going to nerf the light tank, but most likely they are going to do this multiple times over the duration of Battlefield 1. Look at how many times they changed some of the guns in Battlefield Hardline. They said that they're going to make it easier to take out the light tank when you're playing as infantry. They never said anything about tank versus tank, because this is already very balanced. So make sure that you use the information that you saw in this video, and make sure that you are the one who is dominating the battlefield. By the way, the YouTube likes and shares are very helpful to me. If you think that this video is worthy, would you mind taking a moment to like this video and to share it with all your buddies? I would greatly appreciate it. This was Fog of Gaming, thanks for watching, and I will see you on the battlefield.
We have lost Objective George. We have lost Objective Freddy.